Clay, you do have a family involvement in greyhound racing. Your father, Terry, who incidentally owned 2008 Golden Slipper winner Sebring, and his first job was working for renowned breeder Tony Duke, who had one of the biggest breeding operations in Australia in the 60s and 70s.
Yeah, it's definitely been a big influence on me, the things that he learned off Tony Duke and all the people that were involved in that big operation there. I've definitely learned a lot off how they used to operate and things like that, even though it was some time ago, but still little things that he's told me I still use into practice today. So.
And when did you develop an interest in greyhound racing?
I've always been around racing my whole life through my parents, whether it's horses or dogs, but myself grew a particular passion with dog racing from the age of about 15, 16.
Okay, and when did you become actively involved in the sport? Was it as an owner first?
Yeah, as an owner first. Peter Lagargioni trained my first greyhound that I bought as a pup from Melbourne, and which coincidentally was Clay Model, who's going pretty good for me at the moment.
And how long have you been training in your own right?
Myself, I've only been training for about 2 years now, so yeah, still early days.
And how many dogs do you have on the property here at the moment?
There's about 70 odd on the property at the moment, but in the next few months we look to probably have just under 100, hopefully. So
with a fairly big operation like this, you need good staff. You've got to have someone here all the time, and you have a couple of very good staff members that work for you.
Yeah, I've got a very, very handy father and son team, Gary and Luke Adams, who live on the property as well, so they're a huge part in what makes it easy for me, and they're doing what they love, and yeah, they're a big, big help, so I thank them heaps.
Now, you've had great success with the first litter you bred, ironically, by your own bitch Clay Model, who we just talked about, by Collision.
Yeah, she's been enormous for me. She didn't have the best racetrack career, but I knew she had to be good for something, so she's turned out to be a pretty handy producer, and yeah, she's done me great. So
she's of course the mother of probably your kennel star Fast Archer, amongst others, Calm Model.
Yeah, Fast Archer and Calm Model are definitely the two standouts. But the whole litter that she had, every pup to race won, so she definitely can throw a fast pup, and they've all got good racing traits and things like that. So yeah, the two stars are definitely Calm Model and Fast Archer for sure.
And she has another litter who are around 10 months old now, you have down the back there?
Yep, I got another litter of four. Got three dogs, one bitch, by El Gran Senor. They're very, very big pups, which is the only thing I could fault from the first litter was the size. So the size of El Gran Senor has definitely taken part in this breeding. So.
Okay, so it's fair to say Fast Archer has been the best greyhound you've trained so far, and you haven't been afraid to travel with him. You took him to Queensland for the Derby at Albion Park, and also went to Melbourne for a Heat of the Maturity Classic at the Meadows. It must have been a great experience so early in your career to travel with a greyhound.
Yeah, it was a great experience for myself, but also a great experience for the dog. Like, not only has the dog improved since after travelling, but me myself as a trainer learnt a lot, you know, being around other trainers, other states and things like that. You definitely learn a lot.
Now, you've recently put in a new kennel block and also purchased another three maidens. As we said, you've got 70 odd greyhounds on the property, so it looks like you're in greyhound racing for the long haul.
Yeah, I plan to be in it for a very long time, so yeah, the new kennel block is definitely going to keep me busy, but I just need the stock to fill it now. So.
Now, you're a car salesman by profession. You currently own a car yard on Parramatta Road with your father. I guess being a car salesman, that came in pretty handy when you were negotiating buying those three pups recently.
Yeah, definitely comes in handy with everything you negotiate with. But yeah, it's being a car salesman, you definitely know a bit about negotiating, or I'd like to think I do. So.
Clay, you're only in the early stages of your training career. You turn 23 later this month, so you've got a lot of years ahead of you. Where would you like to be in 10 years' time?
10 years' time, hopefully being a successful greyhound trainer still, but maybe a group win or two under my belt would be nice thing to be able to achieve, I guess. So hopefully that would be nice.